kids, it's Pastor Travis, and this is Thursday's Thoughts.
Hey kids, I apologize for eating during the video, but man oh man, I gotta tell you, this is the best chocolate donut I've ever had.
Oh man.
This chocolate donut is delicious. I don't even know if I can do a video. I should probably finish my chocolate donut first before doing the rest of this video. Hold on a second. Man, I never knew a chocolate donut could be so juicy. What do you mean this isn't a chocolate donut? It's not an apple, it's a chocolate donut.
I don't care if you think it's an apple, I think it's a chocolate donut.
Even if you believe that it's an apple, and it's true for you that it's an apple, it's not true for me. Because for me, it's what I want it to be.
It's a chocolate donut. Unfortunately, that's how some people believe Christianity and the Bible is. They think that it's maybe true for us, but it's not true for them. Well, the thing is, there is truth, and your own opinion. There's not my truth, your truth, this person's truth, that person's truth. That's just not the way truth is.
Truth is either true or false. You've never taken a test and it says there are 50 states in the United States. A, true. B, false. C, whatever you want it to be.
That's not the way it is.
It's either true or false.
The Word of God, the Bible, is either true completely from beginning to end, or it is false from beginning to end.
You can't say, well, some part of the Bible is true.
And some part of the Bible is not true. And this part of the Bible, this works for me, but this part I don't really like, so it can't be true.
The entire Bible, from Genesis all the way to Revelation, is all true. It is the Word of God.
I mean, being like that is like saying the apple that I was eating is a chocolate donut, and me believing it's a chocolate donut, therefore it is. It's not going to be a chocolate donut, and no matter how much I want that to be true.
I really could use a chocolate donut right now.
An apple will never, ever, 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 ever
be a chocolate donut.
As much as I would want to believe it's a chocolate donut or say, well, it's a chocolate donut to me. No, no, no. It is an apple. Because an apple is an apple. 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 An apple is an apple.
It's not a chocolate donut.
What's true is true. What's false is false. It's not what's true. It's kind of true for me, but not for you. I'm getting so frustrated because it's hard for me to understand how people just don't understand this.
A red pen. It's 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 a red pen. Well, look at that. I believed enough for it to be a red pen that it's become a red pen. Yay, that's my truth. There's red pen or there's a black pen.
This black pen cannot become a red pen just because I believe it's going to be a red pen.
That's not the way truth works. Truth is either true or it's false. How does this not make sense?
Are you kidding me? Why? Why can't you understand?
Not your truth. It's not my truth. It's truth. Actual truth.
A lot of people don't want to take the Bible, the Word of God, as truth. Because if you read through the Word, it talks about how if you do this bad thing, you will have this bad consequence. People say, well, I don't want to have to deal with that consequence. I'll just believe this isn't a bad thing. I'll just believe it's okay for me to do this thing that's wrong.
And everybody believes and agrees that it's wrong.
I'm just going to say it's not wrong, because then that way I don't have to suffer the consequence that God says it is a consequence in His Word.
That's how they avoid understanding that the Word of God is true.
That the truth is true.
God explains in His Word that if we make a wrong choice, we have to suffer the consequence.
Let's say there's a hot stove. If we touch that hot stove, we're going to burn our hands. Now, the burn is a consequence of us making a bad decision. It's not God punishing us. God has said, don't touch that fire, but I'm going to let you do what you want to do. And when you touch that fire, it burns you. Not because God made it burn you, because God knew that it was going to be hot. It was going to be burning you. Now there's a consequence for what you did.
And that is why a lot of people don't want to take the Bible as true. Because they like this part of the Bible, where it talks about God loving you and caring for you and offering you grace when you make mistakes. But they don't like the part where it says, choose God's way instead of yours. You can say, well, I want to follow this stuff here, but not this stuff. I believe this is true, but I don't believe this is true. Let me tell you something. Everything in the Bible is true.
There's nowhere in the Bible that talks about videos. There's nowhere in the Bible that talks about Facebook or YouTube or the internet. But we believe that that is true. We see that it's true. We know that that is true, that that exists.
People believe that to be true because they can see it. Here's the problem. If you only believe what you can see, then what about wind?
Can you see wind? No, you can see it blowing stuff around, but you can't see wind. What about gravity? You can see something fall, and gravity caused that thing to fall to the earth, but you can't actually see gravity.
And what about dinosaurs? You believe those are real, right?
But you can't see them. Oh, you've seen the bones, but you haven't seen the skin, you haven't seen the muscles. You don't know how they actually looked, but somebody took that information and they said, well, this is the best we can decide on the evidence that we have, so we're going to just take a leap of faith.
Oh, faith. Isn't that a term when it comes to believing the Bible and believing in God that you can't see? How can you apply that to something that you haven't seen, but you believe it's true? dinosaurs. You believe they look like they do in the movies or in the drawing, but you don't know. You don't have any actual evidence. You just believe what somebody wrote who has a little bit more knowledge on the situation based off of facts or based off of their research. Yet we can't believe the Bible being the exact same type of thing. In fact, the Bible actually was written by people who were there in the time of Jesus. Actual firsthand accounts of people. We can't believe that.
But we can believe that the dinosaur had this kind of skin, because judging from the facts of the little bit that we know, we're going to fill in the rest of the gaps.
Sounds like it takes a lot more faith to believe that the Word of God isn't true than to believe that it is. Maybe that's just me. I believe that the Word of God is true from beginning to end. I don't think that there's any falseness in that Bible at all. But don't take my word for it.
No, honestly, don't take my word for it.
I want you to read the Bible yourself. If you don't believe God is real, read the Bible yourself. Trust that you will find the answers, that you'll find truth. If you look into the Bible and research it and try and find actual truth, maybe even pray to this God that you don't think is real, that you don't believe, well, then what would it hurt to actually pray to something that you don't think is real?
I bet things would get better. I will bet. I'm not a betting man, but I would bet.
God would show himself to you and show you that he is truth. Now, I know this video is a little longer than usual, but I really felt like it was on my heart from God to share this with you. So I hope you've stuck around for the entire video. I want us to read a scripture together, and then I want to pray for you that the truth of God and his word would be revealed to you in your heart. So let's look at Psalm
86:11.
Lord, teach me your ways, and I will live and obey your truths. Help me make worshiping your name the most important thing in my life. That's actually the prayer I pray for you. I pray for whoever it is that's watching this video right now, Lord, or if it's somebody that they know, I pray that you help reveal your truth to them. Reveal who you are, that you are the one true living God who sent his son to sacrifice his life, coming down from a kingdom in heaven to be able to be on earth, giving up everything just so that we could live. I pray that truth pierce the heart of somebody today, Lord, and I just thank you for the blessing that they are. I just pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, guys. You have a great, fantastic week. Love you all. God bless. I don't mean... I can't talk. There's a red pen or there's a black pen. Wait, that's the other way around.
The problem with eating food... Well, not eating food in general. But the problem with eating food during my videos is I don't want to waste it. So I feel compelled to constantly eat just the entire thing. And, so sometimes it takes a little longer for me to do these videos. That's ridiculous. Hold on. I'm not going to waste this apple. In fact, if you're thinking, I'm not going to waste it. I'm not an apple waster. It's just good, though. All right. Where was I?